Right, due to a disaster, excuse me, with a certain dog named Billy, he got hold of one of the canopy pieces from the hunter. So while I sent the email off to Revel to get the new part, I thought I'd do a quickie. This one's gonna be a little Epic Spitfire. Obviously, we all started off with these when we were kids. Lovely little kit. This is the new tooling. Not had this one out of the box at all. So we'll open it up and get what we got. Usual thing with Airfix. I hate their little boxes. They're a right pain in the butt. There you go. Right. So, we've got the usual. Everything in one bag, which is fine. I know people moan about it, but I don't. At the end of the day, you're going to put paint on it, so it's not going to get too badly scratched. Instructions with decals. Right. Main body. There's been a lot of moaning about the trench lines. That they say, I mean, on the real plane, those lines would be as thick as my thumb. Which, okay, ain't brilliant, but at the end of the day, it's one of the best 172nd Spitfires you'll buy for this mark. Little bit of detail on the inside, which is pretty good. Wheels are one piece on these, which does help a heck of a lot, and they're weighted. No detail, well, there's a little bit of padding detail on the seat, but we'll come to that later. Nothing major wrong with the kit, apart from the size of the trench lines, or the engraving, I should say. Apart from that, it's a lovely little kit to do. Just the two sprues. Decals, typical Airfix decals. They used to be crap, they're not no more. They are one of the best you'll buy in a box without going to something special. The kit's a skill level one, so suits me down at the ground. I need to get one finished. I haven't finished one for ages now, and it's about time I did. It's going to be the normal, dark earth evergreen with duck egg green bottom and a black one black wing, so should be easy to do. I'm going to remove everything from the sprue. I've done many of these before. I know how they go together, so I'll remove them all and we'll start again from there. So the next job is to get some of the cockpit together. Now, with this one, it's a very simple task. My glue of choice is Tamiya Extra Thin. It's a lovely glue. It gets in it everywhere. Be a little careful of it because it does smell a bit odd. Just place the part on the together, touch the back, and just run a little glue along the bottom. The capillary action will take it up and lock it into place. Give it a few seconds. Hold up and make sure that is fair right angle, like so. And she's there. Right, that could be sat to dry for a few secs. Now, anyone who knows me and seen some of my builds know that I always prime with flat black. I always use Tamiya because I found it's the best, easiest to clean out the airbrush, and seems to work well. The idea behind the primer is to give the paint some depth and give the aircraft some depth. Most of it's going to be lost for what we're now doing, but it will make a difference. Just to give you a little bit of clarity in your airbrush, pour it in neat. As you can see, I haven't used this for a couple of weeks. We've got a little bit of scuff around the lid, which hasn't gone in the airbrush, thank goodness. So be careful of that. Throw that in the bin. Right, just a piece of towel, just to hold it up. Check your flow. I'm running at 20 psi because it's neat. And as you can see, no issues. And then come in from every angle and give it just a light blow over. You don't want too much on it, but you want just a good covering, just to make things give that little bit extra depth and make it look a little bit more interesting. Just make sure you get it all, although obviously it's primer, so it hasn't got to be worry about it too much. That's that bit. Set that to dry for a few seconds because I obviously got a bit where I held it. Again, the front instrument panel, there is black already needed on this, so this will be masked off, ready for the decals as well. So blow that over. That's fine. Now I use stuff from the flower shop. I forgot what it's called, sorry to say. But I mount everything onto cocktail sticks, as you can see, which I want to airbrush for fiddly parts. There is a reason I'm doing it different like this. Normally I put the cockpit together and then spray, but all these parts can have a nice spray over black on the inside and into the foam. I call it foam, I don't know what the real name is for it. It's what you put in the flowers when they put water on them. The prop, while I've got the black in the airbrush, save time, a nice coating. Then that'll be dry later. I will give this a drop of clear over it as well, just to make sure that when I do the tips, which come at a later date, that it doesn't peel the paint from the off the plastic. Right. Looks like a lot on there, but trust me, it isn't. Because they will have metal wheels. I hope you can see this. They'll have metal centers painted in and rubber black painted on the wheels. Right. Anywhere where there's going to be green, spray your black. Anywhere that's going to be seen. Just so that gives that little bit of effect. Normally for the metal work I would use Alclads, but it's a 172 kit and I'm not going to on these bits. Right, the inside of the fuselage, again, spray it over just to give it a depth. It won't be seen, but we know it's there. Both sides. So you haven't got to be perfect with the primer. It's not as if it's ever going to be seen again. But you know you've done it and done the job as best you possibly can. Inside of the wheel wells, give them a coat because that will also be interior green. A little bit more paint. You can dry it off. As you can, don't know if you can see there, there is a mould mark in that area, but it won't show. What else we got here? To do the bottom area of the wings where the intakes are. I always forget to do them. Just spray it in as you're doing.
Did you want any more of that coffee?
Then obviously you clean the airbrush up. Hang on. I think I'm gonna have to teach Lynn when I'm doing this not to talk. Sorry about that. Anyway, that's all the priming done. The only thing really that we need to do is to prime the exhausts, which, yeah, I am going to use Arclads. I always use Arclads for metalwork if I possibly can. It's just stuff that I've enjoyed using over the past. I was lucky enough to be given a complete set of Arclads. I obviously haven't used this for a little while. Right, so this is the Arclad gloss black base. Brilliant stuff. Make sure, like, this is a new bottle, give it a good old shake. It's funny stuff, but it's great to use. Now with this stuff, how can I put it? It's, if you try and pour it in the airbrush, it'll go everywhere. It's very, very thin. You don't need a great deal of it. As you can see, just what, half a mil in the bottom of the brush. Turn the air pressure down to about 10, maybe 12, and then let's just put the lid on that. Spill it goes everywhere and it's awful. So always make sure you put the lid on. Pressure's fine, just slowly look at it, put it on gently, build the colour up so you don't flood it. This is a little bit, takes a little time, but the effect of it is worth it in the end. Make sure you get in everywhere with the stuff. Because if you miss a bit, it'll show. As you, I don't know if you can see or not, but she's quite shiny, and that's how she'll dry. So we'll put that to one side and clean the airbrush up again. Right, so everything's now been primed. We're ready to go with the interior color. Now Spitfire's all interior green, no issues. But with this part, which is the instrument panel, you have a black panel behind and the sights as black as well. So the actual green part needs to be painted black. So basically we need to mask it off while we're spraying, which is a bit of 10mm tomato tape. Excuse my fingers, they're getting a bit mucky. Just get your tomato tape just in the right place to stop anything over spraying, nice and straight. Wrap it round. Right, so the interior colour I'm going to use is 71.010 interior green, Model Air. This stuff is brilliant, but it sits in the bottom here and doesn't mix up very well. What I find is 8mm nuts, I'm nuts, 8mm nuts in the bottle. Use nuts so that they don't block up the bottle. Obviously it's got a point on it. Give it a really good shake. And you can hear that I've got a nut in there. And she's going, mixing it up. Good shake. Okay. Lid off. With Vallejo, always use its own thinners. Always use airbrush the thinners with Model Air, their own Vallejo stuff. If you use anything, anything else, cellulose thinners, X20A, it will go like gloop. It's literally almost like a marshmallow. So always use its own airbrush thinners. My mix is generally just 2 drops. Blow through. Okay, it's mixed up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I always put 11 drops in. Sounds a bit weird, I know, but that's me. And that's it. Mix it up with a brush you know that's not going to leave hairs behind. Okay, spray it so it comes through. Now this is a thin mix, so it's going to spray quite well. Spray it on darts that really don't matter too much. You can see it's very thin. Sometimes you might need to add to the paint. Give it a little bit. So this is just basically for to cover up the black, so it doesn't matter too much on here. I'm going to add a little bit more because that just isn't doing the job that I want it to do properly. So it's nice and a good thickness. Blow through till it comes through a bit thick. That's it. Right. Now we'll get the paint on. This isn't going to be seen, so it's not really a major issue. But obviously work on this until you get your thickness right. Of the colour to do the job. Right, as you can see, I've started to do another piece, and you can see the difference, I hope, that it makes. If you just spray the green on another part, you can see it's opaque, but where that is with the black, it goes on and gives that effect, so you can see the detail. It's going on the sides of the aircraft and underneath. Again, coming in from all angles to make sure you get a nice even colour. I know none of this will be seen, but we know we're doing it. And you could just gradually build the colour up. Don't go mad. That's it. Again, on the other side. Getting all the nooks and crannies. Because you just want that effect. You don't want to go too heavy, because you'll lose that 3D effect. That's why I thin the paint. And always just keep your airbrush moving. Never keep your airbrush in one place. You do that, you'll be in trouble. You'll flutter. And if you do get a little blockage, just pump it a couple of times. She'll run through. Give the airbrush a little wipe. Right. They want the trickier little bits and pieces. So, giving it a nice coat. Not too heavy, because you're going to be picking out the detail on it anyway. So, just a little bit. Doesn't have to be perfect, because you want it to look as though it's used and it's a bit worn and dark. It's that bit inside of the wheels. Obviously we'll pick it out, the detail, once it's been airbrushed. Let's put the pressure up a little bit more. And she's ready. Another wing section. This Vallejo's getting old. I've used it a lot of times now. And really does need to be cleaned out, I think. Use another one. So, give the airbrush a little bit of clean. Whoop, there. As you can see, one of the clean airbrush. Stand it still, that's what happens. Just blow it away because it won't be seen. That's that side of it done. Right, one more piece, which is, well, there are a few more pieces. The bottom of the instrument panel, which has to be painted green. This thin mix still may be a little bit thin, and the pressure's still a little high. So we'll turn it down. As you'll see, we'll get that warm depth look, which you don't get if you give it too much. So again, just go on over this part just to make sure we've got everywhere. So this is an old bottle of Vallejo and it seems to have coagulated a little bit in there. But we'll give it a go just to finish this off. I'll bin this one afterwards. Just the main last piece of the undercarriage to do. And we can set about getting the instrument decal on. Flow seems to be a problem at the moment. As I said, it is the paint, it's not anything else, it is an old tin. But there you go. Right, so that's everything painted with the interior green ready to go.